provided us with tremendous thrills over this past week. Yesterday's men's sprint was no exception. The U.S. national champion, 24-year-old Mark Gorski of Costa Mesa, California, collected the U.S. sixth medal in the cycling. And his lovely wife, Mary, and 13-month-old son, Alexander, were there, and they were looking on. There they are, Mary and Alexander.
Nelson.
And by now you've heard of this man, Nelson Vales, the former New York City bicycle messenger who won the silver. It was a great moment. And it was a great moment for the folks back home in Harlem. Watching the race was quite an event. How about that, Nelson? Nelson's mother Louise and some 30 friends and relatives gathered around the set. And the fact that the outcome was silver and not gold didn't stop the champagne from flowing. And Nelson, Mark, thank you for joining us today. Nelson, that must be, did you know that we had that picture of your family?
Yeah, after I raced, I went up to the ABC booth up top where Eric was, and I called home from there and let my family know the outcome. And they had told me that representatives from ABC were there, and I spoke to one of the gentlemen.
It was a fantastic accomplishment. I've followed the sport of bicycle racing. I'm really not that knowledgeable about it, but having covered it in Montreal somewhat, it just fascinates me to see what you guys can do. Mark, I understand you have credited, really, Nelson with perhaps helping you to the gold medal, but just pushing you so hard this year.
Nelson pushed me a tremendous amount. His gold medal in the Pan Am Games last year was an inspiration that I'm going to have to get out there and work a little bit harder if I was going to be the Olympic gold medalist this year, and he really did push me a tremendous amount.
Gold and silver, that's not bad. Let's go back and take a look on videotape. The final lap of yesterday's action. And perhaps you can help us comment over it. I'll ask you, Mark, first of all, the strategy as we pick it up at this particular point right here.
Well, at this point, I'm trying to maintain the front position as best I can and dictate the pace of the race. I'm trying to keep my eye on Nelson also and trying to control the race from the front.
What were you thinking, Nelson?
Well, I couldn't make my way over the top, so I had to, the best way I can maneuver around Mark was to go underneath and not so far off the track, and he had just shut me off, and the best way I had to do was just to back up and go around again, and by that time it was too late.
By one bicycle wheel, too late. I guess that's how you calculate winning and losing in cycling. Nevertheless, it was a tremendous accomplishment. Let's go back now. We heard the story, you were a messenger in New York City, and if you survive that, dodging the taxi cab, you can survive anything. Did it really begin for you that way, Nelson?
Yeah, it really picked up my cycling career a lot. I used to work for a living at the time, and before I got invited to the Olympic Training Center, I became a messenger to just be on my bike most of the day, and I still trained at night, and it was just big. It just prepared me for the events that are happening now.
Kind of hard to race without that little whistle in there, is really. Mark, let me ask you a question. Where is cycling now in the United States? I know both of you are so enthusiastic about the future of it. Where do you see it right now?
Cycling is at the brink of taking off as a major U.S. sport. I'm just excited to be a part of so many gold medals we've had in cycling. We've had four individual gold medals now in cycling this year. And I'm going to continue in the sport and maybe go on to 88 just to be part of the growth that's going to happen in the sport.
And I bet you will too, won't you, Nelson?
They
interviewed you after that, and it sounded like you were very courteous, said all the right things, but in your eyes you could see, I should have had it. You felt like that, didn't you?
Well, I'm really not satisfied, but I'm happy to have the silver medal because going into this event, I was expected not to do as well as I did. And it was just all the right moves, riding smart, and keeping my eyes on a medal at the games as I approach the line every time I do.
You guys were great.
Line.
Thank you. Proud of both of you, and I agree. Cycling is here, and it's going to get nothing but better. We'll be back as our Olympic coverage continues in just a moment.